Today, we're all reminded that no one is above the law.
No prison time for Margaret Hunter. The wife of former Congressman Duncan Hunter was sentenced this morning to 8 months home confinement and 3 years probation for her role in misusing more than $250,000 in campaign funds for luxury hotels, vacations, and everyday purchases like groceries.
No doubt Ms. Hunter committed very serious crimes, but Ms. Hunter's cooperation was extraordinary.
She cooperated actively. She cooperated early.
Former U.S. Attorney Chuck LaBella says he's not surprised Mrs. Hunter is avoiding prison. She struck a deal with prosecutors to plead guilty and provided key information that ultimately led to her husband's guilty plea.
The earliest opportunity that we gave Ms. Hunter to plead guilty, she accepted that plea offer, pled guilty, and cooperated from that point on.
Prosecutors say Margaret stole the campaign funds with the encouragement of the former congressman. They say turning against him was not easy and put her against the entire Hunter family, ultimately fracturing her marriage with Duncan. Prosecutors say all of that factored into their decision not to ask for prison time.
Anybody who says it's a slap on the wrist just because you get probation or home confinement, I don't think understands the mental anguish and the hardship that individuals who are investigated for months and months and months have to endure, and then after they're in charge or indicted, even after they plead guilty.
Prosecutors now say Margaret is in the process of rebuilding her life, quote, as a single mother, raising questions as to if she's still with the former congressman. And all prosecutors say Margaret simply took responsibility for her actions, while the former congressman was trying to say he was a political target.
I've done nothing wrong and haven't, and they've done that for 2 years.
He blamed his wife, and he attacked the Department of Justice.
For his part, Duncan received 11 months in prison, but because of coronavirus, doesn't have to surrender until January.
We are in uncharted territory, so what happens in January, we're not going to know until we get there.
While she's on home detention, Mrs. Hunter can still leave the house for work, education, religious services, and mental health or substance abuse counseling. Her home detention and probation officially started today. Matt Hoffman, KPBS News.